Electronic cigarettes have become popular with minors too. Proponents say e-cigs help with weaning people off traditional smoking. Still, the number of children taking up the e-cig habit is growing here in Hawaii. Bridget Namata brings us both sides of the issue in tonight's top story.
New findings by the University of Hawaii Cancer Center echoes the State Department of Health's recent youth tobacco survey. More Hawaii teens are using e-cigarettes.
The growth is exploding among adolescents, and also because we don't completely understand why this is.
In 2013, UH polled 1,900 teens aged 14 and 15 from public and private schools. Nearly 30% admitted to trying e-cigarettes. This is significantly higher than their teen counterparts on the mainland.
I saw it often in the schools, but I was more shocked that it was larger than I thought it would be.
This led Dr. Wills and Knight, investigators of the e-cigarette study, to question whether the allure of e-cigarettes are recruiting low-risk youth to tobacco product use, a concern shared by the Hawaii Department of Health. The recent youth tobacco survey found e-cigarette use tripled among high school students and quadrupled among middle school students in the last 2 years. The UH Cancer Center and the State Department of Health believe e-cigarettes are marketed to youth in Hawaii. We stopped by Volcano Vapor Lounge and asked Vice President Scott Rasick, how are teens getting their e-cigs? He doesn't know.
We've never sold to minors. It's been a very strong belief of ours, and I think a lot of the other local retail stores, they share the same belief.
Hawaii law states you must be over 18 to purchase e-cigarettes, but officials say teens are working their way around it. I found it's as easy as clicking yes, that you're of legal age on a website to get your e-cigarettes.
And while Rasick can't deny there are few legal restrictions on e-cigarettes, he denies the products are marketed towards children.
The flavors are there specifically to help people who are trying to make the transition to electronic cigarettes have a successful transition. It's if you give them more options and make it a more pleasurable experience, the transition and success rate is going to significantly improve.
Rasick believes the new findings by UH and the Department of Health are not accurate when you look at them from a broader scale, like helping people quit traditional cigarette smoking.
We have people walking the store every day who have been smoking tobacco cigarettes for 20 years, you know, over a pack a day. And you have to talk to one of these people personally to really understand that they significantly are benefiting.
Dr. Wills and Knight plan on following up with the teens they surveyed over time. They will also study the effectiveness of e-cigarettes in helping people quit smoking. Bridget Namata, KHON2 News.